Hello, my friends. So today I want to talk about the metabolism of experience. But before I do that, I should define what metabolism means. So here's the best definition of metabolism that is accepted by scientists. Metabolism refers to the chemical processes that occur within a living organism in order to maintain life. There are two kinds of metabolism. They're often distinguished from each other. Constructive metabolism, the synthesis of proteins, carbohydrates, and fats that form tissue and store energy. And destructive metabolism, the breakdown of complex substances and the consequent production of energy and waste matter. So that's a standard definition of metabolism. But what is the goal of metabolism? What is the end purpose of metabolism? It is to maintain life in a biological organism, or the experience of life in a biological organism. And healthy metabolism always means self-regulation, homeostasis, the dynamic non-change in the midst of change. So every aspect of metabolism that, of course, expresses itself as various bodily functions is then seen or expressed as a healthy, self-regulating, homeostatic process. So ideal metabolism is where anabolic processes, which means constructive processes, the construction of tissues from carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, and then organs, everything in the body, is a result of metabolism. But so is the destructive process, which is the elimination of waste and the production of energy. So it's a very finely regulated process. So when I was in medical school, we studied these different pathways: lipid metabolism, protein metabolism, carbohydrate metabolism, and all the chemical processes that were responsible for self-regulation, homeostasis, health, healing, wholeness. Given that, the way we were taught about metabolism was basically, it was the metabolism of food. So you ingest food, which has all these chemicals that ultimately result in proteins, lipids, carbohydrates, that then go into the formation of tissues and organs and balance in the body. So blood sugar is maintained with a certain range, and body temperature, cholesterol levels, hormone levels, immune function, everything is within a range of dynamic activity, which is relative non-change in the midst of change. That is ideal. But in medical school, I was only taught the metabolism of food that we ingest. Now, I would say that's a very incomplete understanding of metabolism, because what we metabolize is every experience. We metabolize perceptual experience. We metabolize experience through the five senses, but also through the five subtle senses: sound, touch, sight, taste, and smell, which are referred to as tanmatras. But we also metabolize experience that we call the mind. You know, thoughts, emotions, feelings. We also metabolize our experience of rationality, or the intellect, metabolize the experience that we call self-identity. And then this metabolism of experience actually includes everything from eating, breathing, digestion, of course, the metabolic processes, but elimination also, and thoughts and feelings and emotions and desires and imagination, anything that you can call an experience ultimately is metabolized as the signature or the symbolic representation of a more fundamental level of existence or being that we call awareness or consciousness. So all experience is processed in awareness or consciousness. I'll repeat that. All experience is processed in awareness or consciousness. Now we know that awareness doesn't have a form. It can't be seen or touched or heard or tasted or smelled or even imagined, because awareness is non-conceptualizable. It actually expresses itself as concepts. It expresses itself as ideas. It expresses itself as sensations, sense modulations. It expresses itself as emotions, feelings, thoughts, etc. But awareness itself is inconceivable. Why? Because it doesn't have a form. And not having a form, it is unbounded, limitless, and being formless, it is infinite, spaceless, timeless. It has only the following qualities. It is self-regulating. It is self-evolving. It is self-organizing. It is creative. It is a field of possibilities. It is unpredictable. It is the source of attention and intention. And it is what modifies itself symbolically as mind, intellect, ego, which is called the subtle body, which is metabolized as what we call the conceptual or physical or karmic body, which is the symbolic representation of all experience. But since experience is processed in awareness, that means all experience is processed non-locally, outside of space-time. Its signatures, its symbolic representations are this body and all this. It's me, you, other biological organisms, but also what we perceive as rocks, stones, plants, stars, galaxies. These are all symbolic representation of awareness, not only modifying itself as mind, intellect, ego, subtle body, physical body, or that which we call the physical body, and that which we call the physical universe, the human experience of the physical universe. And ideally, that metabolism is an integrated, unified process in awareness or consciousness, where body, mind, and the world are an integrated expression, symbolic expression of the metabolism of experience. Your body is the metabolism of experience, signature, as is the world that you perceive. It's both recycled and also it evolves. Now, here's something you need to understand, maybe, and that is metabolism, therefore, is influenced by experience moment by moment, second by second, instant by instant. And at the most fundamental levels, that expression of metabolism is at the level of energy and information. The smallest unit of energy and information, in which waves of energy are emitted or absorbed, the smallest unit of that is referred to as a quantum. Quantum simply means quantity, the smallest quantity. So when we say quantum metabolism, quantum body, we're talking about the most fundamental level at which your body is being regulated, at which your body is being regulated. Now, of course, you know that in 1988, I wrote a book called Quantum Healing, which was vilified by the academic media, although some people did relate to it. And now, you know, a lot of time has gone by. 1988 plus, that's 12 years, plus 22 years, that's, that's 34 years have gone by. And I'm writing a new book now. It's called Quantum Body. And it is about quantum metabolism and how you can regulate your metabolism at the most fundamental level for health, well-being, evolution of consciousness, and actually freedom from all suffering. I know that I've been criticized by academics, not being a physicist or a theoretical physicist or a mathematician, for kind of popularizing what we call quantum mysticism. That's the big criticism. And many people have criticized me, academics, for not even being wrong, so far out that it's not even worth talking about. But I have been teaming up with quantum physicists and mathematicians and cosmologists to make sure that what I'm saying is actually quite legitimate. Of course, standard quantum physics right now with multiverse theories and string theory does not need consciousness as part of the explanation of what fundamental processes are. Although the Copenhagen School, and the pioneers of quantum physics, Max Planck and people like Schrodinger and others, right in the beginning, in the Copenhagen interpretation, actually that includes Niels Bohr, were very focused on how consciousness or measurement, which of course requires a conscious process, actually results in what is called the collapse of the wave function, which appears as a physical event, although it's a space-time event in consciousness. So notwithstanding all the criticism and controversy around this, my new book is in partnership with somebody called Jack Tuzinski, who's a quantum physicist from Poland, but he's also a professor at various institutions in Europe and also in Canada, and with another endocrinologist, neuroendocrinologist, who does also believe in the quantum model for the body and for its metabolism. So slowly we are getting there, and this book is almost done, so it'll be out sometime next year. Quantum Body, Quantum Metabolism, which is the future of our understanding of well-being and is something that is amenable to measurement at the most fundamental levels. I think we have to get to that level in biology. Biology has kind of been left behind. And in biology, we still think of complexity as an emergent phenomenon. And we still think in reductionist terms, when in fact, your body is the perfect example of entanglement or non-local correlation. As I've mentioned before, a human body can think thoughts, play a piano, kill germs, remove toxins, make a baby all at the same time, while tracking the movement of stars and planets and embodying them as its own biological rhythm. So entanglement, superposition, non-local correlation, synchronicity is actually an inherent part of how metabolism operates. And this can only occur if metabolism is regulated in a field of awareness that is outside of space-time. only by being at that level outside of space-time. Quantum mechanics operates outside space-time. And so your body's metabolism is also regulated by you, the real you, which is pure awareness, and that real you exists outside of space-time, projects the theater of space-time and causality as its signature, and also that which we call the physical body with quantum metabolism as its expression. If we understand this, a new era of medicine is at hand, and we will begin to understand quantum biology, quantum metabolism, quantum body, and know that we are the source of its regulation. And when we transcend to that source through the quietening of what we call vrittis, or fluctuations that appear as sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts, then that level of transcendence or samadhi is the level where the body actually is perfectly regulated, and also metabolic activity is at the level of least expenditure of energy, and therefore at the level of quantum processes without any interference. And that is what healing is, that is what wholeness is, and this has implications not only for a healthy and long life, but also, yes, extending health span and longevity through the metabolism of experience, including what we call the metabolism of the experience of time. That was the basis of ageless body, timeless mind. And so what is the timeless mind? It's pure consciousness. And what is the ageless body? It's the universe itself, of which you are a particular expression, signature in space and time. So more on this, let me know if you're interested in quantum metabolism and these ideas, and I will continue to share them with you. And I look forward to sharing the book with you as well very soon. Thank you. Hope you have a great day. Thank you.